In this lesson, I want to show you how to create a three-panel agomagraph. This specific project is used in beginner art, the topic being movement and rhythm, which is two of the seven principles of design that you'll learn about in this course. An agomagraph is a type of artwork composed of two or more separate images. As the viewer passes by the artwork, the image morphs from one image to the second and the third, creating an illusion. Just a tiny history, the word agomagraph is named after the artist Jacob Agam, who was best known for his contributions to optical illusions and kinetic art. To create this artwork, we start by creating three separate pieces. For example, I chose to use arrows and lines as my subject, and in each picture they change directions, one vertical, one horizontal, and one diagonal. I also change the color scheme in each. One is cool colored, one is warm colored, and one is neutral colored. After you create your pieces, you want to flip them over and measure 1-inch strips. Each picture is labeled differently, one being labeled A, one labeled B, and one labeled C. This will help you when it comes to placing them on your paper. After the pieces are cut, you will then label A9 through 1, B9 through 1, and C9 through 1. You'll notice the number of the strips are backwards. This is because your image flipped when you flipped it over. Once you start placing the strips on your base paper, it will be in order. After you label your strips and cut them, you will take a long, thick piece of paper and measure strips that are 1 inch thick and 12 inches long. This is the exact size of the strips that you cut on your paper, and they'll fit nicely onto the paper when you glue them down. After you have measured out your paper, you will then label each strip VHH, which stands for Valley Hill Hill, which is how you will fold your paper. Valley is a flat surface and hill will be folded. You'll repeat this pattern all the way down the paper. When your paper is folded, you will glue the hills together and add paper clips to secure them in place while they dry. After your hills are nice and dry, you will then glue them to your folded base paper to a After your hills are nice and dry, you will then glue your folded base paper to a colored backer paper. I chose black for my example. Any color could work, is up to the artist to choose. I also realized as I was working that I needed an extra strip for each picture, so I simply measured a 3-inch wide, 12-inch long paper, folded it, and attached it to the end of my other folded base paper. As you can see, it isn't noticeable at all, and I tucked it right in. When you have secured your folded base paper to the backer paper, you can now start placing your cut strips accordingly. You will start with A and begin laying your strips down in place and secure them with glue. Remember to take your time. After the pieces are secured, press firmly on the strips, smoothing them out and helping them dry properly. I also like to add my paper clips back as they dry to make sure everything is nice and neat. Take your paper clips off and voila! You have completed a three-panel agomagraph.
Clean up, clean up, everybody else.
Wipe, wipe, wipe it down. Wipe, 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 wipe it down.